The voice of the angels roar. blessed by the messages and the workshop today. In Jesus' name we pray.
Yeah, you may be seated.
Switch to fishy, but
well, while we try to fix this, this reminds me of Revelation 14:12. Here's their endurance, the endurance of the saints.
Here's the endurance of the saints.
성도들의 인내가 여기 있나니가 생각납니다. 계시록.
The he who, you know, many will be called, but few will be saved.
많은 사람들이 부름을 받지만 몇 명만 소수만
This is what I'm reminded of this morning.
구원을 받는다.
Whatever happened to the 250 other people that were there yesterday?
250명 어떻게 됐는지 모르겠는데 어제 왔던.
Thank you for coming.
와주셔서 감사합니다.
So should we wait? Oh no, we got it.
Yeah, we got it.
We got it. Great. Thank you. All right. We're going to talk about the meaning of Christ in me.
내 안에 그리스도가 계신다는 것의 의미.
And before we do that, let's bow our heads one more time for prayer. Father in heaven,
하늘에 계신 아버지,
we thank you for this glorious morning we can meet together.
이 영광스러운 아침에 우리가 만날 수 있어서 감사합니다.
We thank you for another opportunity to hear from your word.
하나님의 말씀을 들을 수 있어서 감사합니다.
And we pray that you guide our thoughts,
우리 생각을 지도해 주시고,
so that we can respond to you and we can meditate on what you have in mind for us.
하나님께 반응하고 하나님께서 준비하신 것들을 명상할 수 있도록 도와주옵소서.
In Christ's name we pray.
예수님 이름으로 기도합니다.
Amen. Okay. A few years ago,
몇 년 전에,
there was a very fierce civil war in Sudan.
수단에 내전이 있었습니다.
It went on for a couple of decades.
수년 동안 계속했습니다.
And basically the north part of Sudan
북쪽 지방에
is Muslim and the south part of Sudan is
지방이고,
animist and Christian is a mixture.
남쪽 지방에는 그리스도인도 있고 막 섞여 있습니다.
The northern people were the powerful ones and they You may have seen pictures or on television. They hacked people's arms and legs off.
북쪽 사람들 굉장히 잔인한 사람들인데 막 팔 자르고 다리 자르고 막 그럽니다.
So there are there's an entire generation of people without limbs because of that war.
어떤 세대는 아예 팔다리가 없어요.
The result of that is that eventually in 2011. They separated and South Sudan was born as an independent nation.
2011년에 남수단이 떨어져 나갔습니다.
It's a very very poor, very struggling nation. It's barely surviving.
엄청 가난하고 찢어지게 가난.
Because it's never really recuperated from the war.
전쟁 때문이죠.
During the war, many people escaped, tried to escape South Sudan. Of course, they couldn't go to the North Sudan.
남수단에서 탈출하려고 그랬어요. 북쪽으로 못 가죠.
Because they would get killed.
가면 죽으니까.
So they emigrated to Uganda, which is just south of South Sudan.
그래서 남수단 남쪽에 있는 우간다로 도망갑니다.
And other countries, but mostly Uganda, to refugee camps.
거기 난민촌.
There was a man who had lost his entire family, who decided he needed to get out of the country to survive.
난민촌에 가족이 다 죽은 사람이 있었습니다.
And in order to get out of the country, he walked during the night and slept on treetops during the daytime.
밤새 걷고 낮에는 나무 위에 올라가고.
Otherwise, they would find him and they would probably capture him and either kill him or torture him.
사울은 죽이고 고문하고 그러니까.
So he walked a long time.
오래 걸어가지고.
All the way until he finally got to Uganda.
우간다까지 갔습니다, 결국.
And he walked about 240 kilometers.
240km 걸어가지고.
That's not a picnic, you know. That's not a casual walk.
엄청 길죠.
But he made it to Uganda.
결국 가서.
And after a while, he met an Adventist pastor there.
재림교회 목사를 만납니다.
An old man who had also escaped, and he was also a refugee, and they befriended each other, and they started studying the Bible together.
그 사람도 나이가 많고 이제 재림교인인데 성경 공부를 같이 하게 됩니다.
After a few weeks and months, perhaps.
며칠 후, 몇 달 후.
This young man decided, I want to join the Seventh Adventist Church. And so the old pastor baptized him as a new member of the Seventh Adventist Church in the refugee camp.
그래서 난민촌에서 침례자가 생깁니다.
Of course, his great desire was to share his faith with other people.
전도를 하고 싶어서 이 사람이.
His family was gone, but he had friends back in South Sudan.
가족은 다 죽었지만 내가 남수단으로 가서 친구들한테 복음을 전해야겠다.
He told the pastor one day, "I'm going back."
저 다시 갈 거예요.
Are you're doing what?
다시 간다고?
I am going back to South Sudan to share what I've learned from you and from the Bible with other people.
하나님한테 배운 거 다른 사람한테 알려줄 거예요.
And so he walked 240 kilometers. Home again during the nights and slept on treetops during the day.
그래서 온 것처럼 똑같은 형태로 다시 돌아갑니다. 240km.
Can you imagine? He made it back.
그래서 결국 가서.
He started sharing with some of the friends that he had in his village.
그래서 전도하기 시작합니다.
After a while, there were 7 or 8 of them ready to join him as a member of the Seventh Adventist Church.
그래서 일곱 여덟 명이 침례받을 준비가 되었습니다.
And of course, they needed to be baptized.
침례.
And but no one. I mean, he only knew one pastor.
근데 목사님 하나밖에 몰라요.
And that pastor was in Uganda in a refugee camp.
그래서 거기 다시 가야 됩니다.
So he says, "I'm going to get that pastor to baptize you."
목사님 데려와야 되겠다.
And you can imagine what happens next, right?
이제 뭐 했을까요?
So he walked another 240 kilometers to the refugee camp. And now you have to remember that every time he's walking, he's taking his hand, his life in his hand.
그래서 목숨 걸고 또 갑니다. 그 거리.
He doesn't know who's going to catch him. He doesn't know who is, you know, whether he's going to make it for one more day.
죽을지도 모릅니다. 가다가.
But he makes it to Uganda.
결국 갑니다.
And 도착합니다. He tells the pastor, "I have several other men who are ready to become members of the Seventh Adventist Church. Please come and baptize them."
여기 침례 좀 주세요, 목사님.
But the old man says, "Oh, my brother, I could never survive the trip."
근데 목사님이 나는 못 가겠어.
I will never make it. I'm too old for that trip. And
나이가 많고.
You know, it's 240 kilometers.
It's not
like you can take the bus.
어떻게 가니? 버스도 없는데.
Now this is desert and
사막이고.
In you know difficult areas.
너무 어려워.
So he decided to go back to his former home.
그래서 옛날 집으로 가서
240 kilometers walking during the nights and sleeping on treetops during the day so he would not be seen and he
숨으려고.
Finds the friends who are anxiously waiting for him.
그래서 친구들이 기다리고 있었어요.
And he says to them, "Good news.
좋은 소식 있어.
I have a pastor who's willing to baptize you."
내가 목사님 있는데 침례받게 해 줄게.
All we have to go, all we have to do is go to him.
다시 나랑 같이 가자.
And the man say, "Great."
Okay, 가자.
So now 7 or 8 of them are walking during the nights and sleeping on treetops during the day and walking 240 kilometers.
친구들도 똑같이 갑니다. 나무에서 자고 또 자고.
In order to be baptized, can you believe that?
침례 받으러 갑니다.
How much did you have to walk in order to be baptized?
여러분 침례 받을 때 얼마나 걸으셨어요?
You probably drove to the church to do that.
아마 차 타고 갔을 거예요, 대부분.
And so They finally get there and they're baptized as brand new members of the Seventh Day Adventist.
침례를 받습니다. 그 사람들이.
And what do you think happened next?
다음에는?
How would you end this story?
어떻게 끝날 거야, 얘기가?
It's a fascinating ending. Because they didn't decide to stay there. I mean, the logical thing would be to stay in the relative safety of the refugee camp.
대부분 남미션에 머물 텐데.
They were away from danger from South Sudan.
안전하니까.
They had a support mechanism. They had food and shelter.
밥 주고 먹여주고 다 좋으니까.
But they didn't stay.
네.
They decided to walk back.
다시 걸어갑니다. 남수단으로.
To South Sudan. But this time it took them many weeks.
오, 몇 주 동안.
Much longer than before.
정말 오랫동안.
Because they decided to stop at several villages along the way.
왜냐면 마을들을 들렀어요.
And they share their faith and their love for God.
전도를 합니다. 하나님이 너무 좋아요.
And so they would stay 2 weeks here, they would stay 3 weeks there.
2주, 3주.
And so forth and so on. Now, what makes somebody walk 1,200 kilometers?
1,200km 어떻게 걸을 수 있었을까?
To do all this dangerous kilometers, not just
위험한 곳입니다.
Casual
위험한
walk in the park type thing.
어려워요.
The only answer to that is this man was full of the love of Jesus.
He 예수님의
Jesus
사랑이 가득했죠.
Was real in his life. So real in his life that he decided to do this. He could not do this.
예수님께서 살아계신 능력이었습니다.
This was the most important thing.
근데 실체였습니다.
This is what mattered. It gave him life.
Therefore, 가장 중요한.
He wanted to share life with others.
다른 사람들한테 이걸 전해줘야겠다.
The night Jesus was betrayed,
예수님이 배반당하신 날.
He spent a most intimate few hours with his disciples.
아주 친밀한 시간을 가졌는데 제자들이랑.
He had a great need that night. Jesus knew that he would be crucified probably before the end of the next of the within the next 24 hours.
이제 조금 있으면 돌아가실 거 알았습니다. 십자가에서.
Because that night began Passover day and he knew
시작되고.
Based on Exodus 12 that he would die on Passover.
그래서 그 출애굽기 12장에 따르면은 유월절에 죽으니까.
So his great need was the love and support of his friends.
그때 친구들의 사랑과 지원이 필요했어요.
We usually don't think about how Jesus feels. We think about how we feel, but we don't think about how Jesus feels.
우리는 우리 기분만 생각하지 예수님 기분 생각 안 합니다.
Jesus was going to be accused and mistreated. And abandoned by his own people.
남용당하고 버림당하고 자기 백성들에 의해서.
The very people he came to save.
구하려고 온 바로 그 백성.
None of the great leaders were willing to step out in faith and say, "We'll follow you."
그 어떤 지도자들도 하나님 따를게, 예수님 따를게 안 했습니다.
Nicodemus and Joseph were two of the members of the Sanhedrin, but they did not step out publicly before his death.
요셉, 니고데모, 예수님 죽음 전에 공개적으로 나서지 않았습니다.
He had no support from any other the Pharisees or the scribes or the important influential people in Jerusalem.
굉장히 유명한 사람들 아무도 안 나섰습니다.
The only thing he had were these 12.
12명밖에 없어요.
Oh, he had thousands of people who admired him.
수천 명이 좋아하긴 했죠.
And hundreds of people who were faithful to him.
수백 명이 따르는 사람도 있었어요, 예수님.
But none really understood what he was about to go through.
근데 아무도 예수님의 그 심정을 알지 못했어요.
So that night he wanted to explain that to them.
그래서 그걸 설명하고 싶었어요.
That night he sought for them to understand what was the most important moment in the history of humankind.
인류에서 가장 중요한 순간.
No doubt Jesus would have liked to have talked about the meaning of the cross.
십자가의 의미.
Or the meaning of self-sacrifice.
자기 희생
or about salvation
구원
or about the kingdom of God
하나님의 왕국
or about how all of these things would be accomplished according to God's will
그 모든 것들이 하나님의 뜻을 어떻게 이루는지
and he no doubt would have liked to have had the support of his disciples saying Jesus we're praying with you we will be with you with God all things are possible
제자들이 예수님 저 그렇게 할게요 도와드릴게요 근데 그렇게 하지 않았습니다.
But none of that came from those disciples.
안 했습니다, 제자들 그렇게.
And it makes sense because about 9 months before Jesus began to tell them what happened to him.
9개월 전부터 나 죽을 거야, 나 죽을 거야.
He told them that he would be taken at the hand of Gentiles, that he would be crucified.
체포되고 이방인들한테.
On the third day he would rise again.
십자가형 당하고 부활할 거야.
But that went in one ear and out the other. They didn't understand what he meant by that.
제대로 이해를 못했어요.
At one point, in you read it in John 13, he says, "I am leaving you."
요한복음 13장 난 너를 떠난다.
And they immediately get desperate.
그때 너무 절박했어요.
What do you mean you're leaving?
무슨 말이에요?
Of course, he was making reference to after accomplishing his ministry, he was going to go back to heaven.
예수님의 사역을 끝내고 하늘로 돌아갑니다.
But they despaired. They immediately thought of themselves. What's going to happen to us?
나한테 어떻게 되지? 절망했어요.
If you're leaving.
하나님 있으면 떠나네.
And so Jesus changed his objectives that evening.
그날 예수님의 목적이 바뀝니다. 목표.
Instead of expecting much from them and the support that he needed from them, he decided to give support to them.
예수님이 원했던 그 기대와 기대를 낮추시고 그들에게 지원을 해주십니다.
He decided to comfort them by telling them about the Holy Spirit who would come.
성령 하나님에 대해서 위로.
And that that Holy Spirit would be another one just like himself.
나 같은 사람이 올 거야.
Who would be with them and provide for them and teach them and guide them through the rest of their life.
나 같은 인격체가 와서 도와주고 가르쳐주고 다 해줄 거야. 나랑 똑같이.
Jesus said in John
14:16,
I will ask the Father, and he will give you another helper that he may be with you forever.
내가 아버지께 구하겠으니 그가 또 다른 보혜사를 너희에게 주사 영원토록 너희와 함께 있게 하리니.
I can't be with you forever.
나 이제 가야 돼.
But he will be with you forever.
성령께서 함께 하실 거야.
And the word that he used is that is translated in the New King James's helper is the word parakletos.
보혜사. Paracleto.
Parakletos is a Greek word that means one alongside the other.
그리스어로 바로 옆에 있는 사람.
In English, we have the word parallel or paralegal.
그래서 바로 옆에 이렇게.
And we get that from the Greek. That
평,
means
평행으로.
Something that is just like something else.
그래서 다 똑같은 거.
So the Holy Spirit is just like Jesus.
예수님이랑 똑같습니다.
With the exception that he will be with them for how long?
Forever.
All right?
예수님은 잠깐, 성령 하나님은 영원히.
In the next chapter, we read, when the Helper comes, whom I will send to you from the Father, he will bear witness of me.
내가 아버지께로부터 너희에게 보낼 보혜사가 오실 때에 그가 나를 증언하실 것이요.
In other words, the assumption is, you've been with me for 3.5 years, but you still do not know me.
3년만 동안 나랑 같이 있었는데 아직도 나를 모르는 거야.
The Holy Spirit will have to teach you about me.
성령 하나님께서 나에 대해서 너희들한테 더 가르쳐 주셔야 돼.
Back to John 14, he said, he will teach you all things and bring to your remembrance all that I said to you.
그가 너희에게 모든 것을 가르치고 내가 너희에게 말한 모든 것을 생각나게 하리라.
And then in chapter 16, we read, when he, the Spirit of truth, comes, he will guide you into all truth.
그러나 진리의 성령이 오시면 그가 너희를 모든 진리 가운데로 인도하시리니.
For he will not speak on his own initiative, but whatever he hears, he will speak.
그가 스스로 말하지 않고 오직 들은 것을 말하며 장래일을 너희에게 알리시리라.
He shall glorify me, for he shall take of mine and shall disclose it to you.
그가 내 영광을 나타내리니 내 것을 가지고 너희에게 알리시겠습니다.
The longest discourse
가장 긴
on the Holy Spirit in the entire Bible is found from that evening of Jesus.
성령 하나님에 대한 가장 긴 가르침입니다. 성경에서.
5 chapters in the book of John are dedicated to that single evening encounter.
그 한 이야기 5장에 걸쳐서 요한복음.
That's 1/4 of the book of John.
4분의 1입니다. 요한복음.
So what happened that night is extremely important.
굉장히 중요하죠. 그
And it
사건이.
And it would be very useful for us to study those 5 chapters. John 13 to 17.
13장에서 17장까지 우리가 공부할 필요가 있어요.
In 3 of those chapters, he spoke exclusively about who the Holy Spirit is.
성령 하나님이 누구냐?
14, 15 and 16.
14장에서 16절까지.
So, to summarize, he said to them, the Holy Spirit will bear witness of Jesus.
예수님을 증언하고
The Holy Spirit will teach what Jesus taught.
예수님이 가르친 거 가르치시고
And the Holy Spirit would glorify Jesus.
예수님의 영광 나타내고
You notice that there's a pattern here, right?
패턴이 있어요.
The pattern is that the Holy Spirit is not about himself.
자기 자신을 밝히시는 분이 아니에요.
Everything the Holy Spirit is doing is about Jesus.
예수님에 관한 것을 하세요.
In fact, I have written on the Holy Spirit a number of times because I've done a lot of study on it.
제가 성령에 관해서 많이 공부하고 책도 많이 썼는데.
And in one of the articles, I make the case that the Holy Spirit shows the typical divine humility in his person.
신성이 나타내는 특별한 그 겸손함.
Because the Bible tells us who the author of the Bible is.
성경의 저자.
And who is the author of the Bible?
누가 저자입니까?
The Holy Spirit.
성령.
And yet, very little in the Bible is said about the Holy Spirit.
근데 성령 하나님에 대해서 얘기가 굉장히 적어요.
Because his purpose is not to tell us about him. His purpose is to tell us about Jesus.
그분의 목적은 예수님을 높이는 거예요.
And that's why most of the Bible is all about Jesus.
그래서 거의 대부분 예수님에 관한 거예요.
And then about the Father.
하나님 아버지.
And then about the church.
교회.
But not about himself.
자기 자신 아닙니다.
That's why some people think the Holy Spirit is mysterious.
그래서 정말
No, that's the
신비스럽죠.
choice of the Holy Spirit to be that way.
성령 하나님이 선택한 거예요.
Because he knows that human beings, what they need is to see the more visual, the easiest representation of God, which is in the form of a human being, such as Jesus.
사람들은 쉽게 하나님을 접하고 싶으니까 예수님이 굉장히 쉽죠. 이해하기가.
And so Jesus said again in John 14, I will ask the Father and he will give you the spirit of truth whom the world cannot receive.
내가 아버지께 구하겠으니 그가 성령 하나님을 너희에게 주사 그는 진리의 영이라 세상은 능히 그를 받지 못하는.
Because he does not behold him or know him, but you know him because he abides with you and will be in you.
이는 그를 보지도 못하고 알지도 못함이라 그러나 너희는 그를 아나니 그가 너희와 함께 거하시며 또 너희 속에 계시겠습니다.
Notice he said two important things. He says the world cannot receive the Holy Spirit. He said the world cannot receive the Holy Spirit.
세상은 나를 못 받아.
And that's why he says I will send him to you. I will send him to the church.
그래서 교회에게 보낼 거야.
And then it says that the Holy Spirit will be in you.
너한테 보낼 거야. 네 속에 계실 거야.
Will not be with you. Will be in you.
함께 계실 뿐 아니라 네 안에.
And that's a significant prepositional change.
굉장히 중요한 전치사의 변화죠.
Every mother knows the difference between having a child with her and having a child in her.
엄마는 알죠. 자궁에 있는 거랑 옆에 있는
거랑. And when a mother recognizes she has a child in her, she also recognizes something else.
내 안에 아이가 있는 건 느낌이 달라요.
She recognizes that her life will change forever.
그래서 아이가 내 속에 생기면 그녀의 삶이 바뀌어요.
And Jesus is making this point that once you receive the Holy Spirit, things are going to really change in you.
성령 하나님이 네 속에 계시면 완전히 달라질 거야, 삶이.
He continued to say, I will not leave you as orphans. I will come to you.
내가 너희를 고아 같이 버려두지 아니하고 너에게 오리라.
The fact that I'm leaving you doesn't mean I'm forgetting about you.
난 너를 까먹는 게 아니야.
And then he said, The world will behold me no more, but you will behold me.
세상은 나를 보지 못하지만 너는 나를 바라볼 거야.
Now, how do you understand that?
무슨 말이죠?
The world will behold me no more. That means I will not be here. They can't see me.
세상은 내가 없으니까 여기 날 못 보고.
But because of the Holy Spirit, you will understand more about me than now when you see me.
내가 여기 있었던 때보다 성령 하나님이 네 안에 있으니까 나를 더 잘 이해할 거야.
And that's why it says you will behold me.
나를 바라볼 수 있어.
You will really see me.
나를 볼 거야.
For who I am.
내가 누군지.
After I leave.
내가 떠난 다음에.
In fact, in chapter 16, two chapters later, it says, "It is to your advantage that I go."
요한복음 16장에 내가 가는 게 더 좋아.
So that our relationship can be even closer together.
우리 관계가 더 가까워질 거야.
Than what it is now.
지금보다 더.
And then he finishes saying, "Because I live, you shall live also." In that day. You shall know that I am in my Father, and you in me, and I in
You는 내가 살아 있고 너희도 살아 있겠음이라 그날에는 내가 아버지니 너희가 내 안에서 내가 너희 안에 있는 것을 너희가 알리라.
It's interesting that twice in a single in this portion he emphasizes the fact that Jesus will be in them.
그리스도께서 네 안에 계실 것이야.
Whereas Jesus had been with them, now Jesus will be in them.
나는 지금까지 너희와 함께 했지만 이제 미래에는 내가 너희 안에 있을 거야.
That's a profound difference.
굉장히 심오한 진리죠.
That's a profound difference. I mean, in human relations, you cannot get more intimate than when somebody is in another.
사람 간의 관계에 있어서 누군가 속에 들어간다는 거 굉장히 심오한 일이에요.
And that is conveyed here. I will be in you.
네 안에 있을 거야.
Whereas before, I have up until now, I have been with you.
너와 친밀해질 거야.
So what Jesus is trying to tell the disciples is that through the coming of the Holy Spirit, they would have a much more intimate relationship than even what they had up until then.
내가 너희와 함께 있었던 것보다 내가 너보다 더 친해질 거야.
And after those 10 days, in fact, Jesus continued, one last statement. In that day, you shall know that I'm in my Father, and you in me, and I in you.
그날에는 내가 아버지 안에, 너희가 내 안에, 내가 너희 안에 있는 것을 너희가 알리라.
What did Jesus mean by saying in that day?
그날이 무슨 날이죠?
What day is that day?
어떤 날이죠?
The day of? Day of Judgment?
심판?
No, before that.
그 전.
The Day of Pentecost. The
오순절.
Day of Pentecost.
오순절.
Remember, elsewhere he told them, tarry in Jerusalem until you have received power from on high. Until that Holy Spirit has come in your
life.
And then, Ellen White describes this in several pages of her book, The Acts of the Apostles.
Ellen White의 사도행정에서
In the English version, you can read that in pages 35 to 38.
35쪽에 38쪽.
And she says that the disciples were so joyful. They were so filled with God.
제자들이 너무 하나님과 함께해서가지고 너무 기뻐가지고.
That they truly understood how close they were now to Jesus.
예수님과 얼마나 친밀한지를 이해했다.
And it was that which produced what we know as Pentecost, that which is you know, the power of God through
성령 하나님이 임했습니다.
So, when I receive the Holy Spirit,
성령 하나님을 받아들이면,
what I really get is Jesus.
내 안에 그리스도가 오십니다.
So, when the Holy Spirit came on those disciples, what they received was Jesus Christ, but no longer with them, but in them.
성령께서 그들 안에 오셨을 때 그리스도가 그 안에 계셨죠. 제자들 안에.
Ellen White says transformation of character is the testimony to the world of an indwelling Christ.
품성의 변화는 마음속에 그리스도가 내재하신다는 증거다.
It's not the testimony of an intellectual Christ.
지적인 게 아니고요.
It's not a testimony of a Christian philosophy.
철학이 아닙니다.
It's the testimony that Christ actually lives in you.
네 안에 있다. 증거.
That is when things really start making a difference.
그때 차이가 생깁니다.
And she continues to say the Spirit of God produces a new life in the soul, bringing the thoughts and desires into obedience to the will of Christ.
하나님의 성령은 영혼 속에 새 생명을 나게 하시고 생각과 욕망을 그리스도의 뜻에 복종케 하신다.
The Christian church today can be divided into three categories.
세 개의 종류가 있습니다, 교회가.
You have Catholics,
Catholic.
You have Protestants,
개신교.
And you have Charismatics.
그리고 Charismatic.
Along with the Catholics, you can add the Orthodox.
거기에 정통.
They're not the same thing, but they're similar.
정교.
All right. The charismatics are the fastest growing branch of Christianity.
기독교에서 카리스마 그 교회가 가장 빨리 자랐는데.
In barely 100 years, they have grown to be over 700 million people.
그때 7억 정도 있었습니다.
So some think that you receive the Holy Spirit sometime after you're a Christian.
Sorry.
Some think that you receive the Holy Spirit after you're a Christian.
어떤 사람들 우리가 그리스도인이 된 이후 어떤 시점에 성령 하나님을 받는다고 생각해요.
That's what charismatics think.
그게 카리스마.
Charismatics think, you know, after you become a Christian, then you start walking with God, and one day you're going to really get it, and you're going to get the Holy Spirit.
근데 그리스도인 되면 언젠가 이렇게 하다가 이렇게 받는다.
Usually, what they mean by that is that you're going to start speaking in tongues, and now you know that the Holy Spirit is.
방언하니까 성령님이 계신 거야.
However. Yeah, and this is called, this is known in theology as the second blessing.
신학적으로 두 번째 축복.
What would be the first blessing? The first blessing would be receiving Jesus as your personal savior.
예수님 받아들이는 거.
And the second blessing would be receiving the Spirit.
성령 하나님 두 번째.
But is that what the Bible teaches?
성경이 어떻게 말할까요?
In Romans 8, verse 9, we read, if anyone does not have the Spirit of Christ, he does not belong to him.
누구든지 그리스도의 영이 없으면 그리스도의 사람이 아니라.
And if Christ is in you, the Spirit is alive. But if the Spirit dwells in you, he who raised Christ Jesus from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies through his Spirit who indwells you.
또 그리스도께서 너희 안에 계시면 영은 살아있는 것이니라. 예수를 죽은 자 가운데 살리신 이의 영이 너희 안에 거하시면 너희 안에 거하신 그의 영으로 말미암아 너희 죽을 몸도 살리시리라.
In other words, when you read these texts, it is very clear to Paul that you cannot receive the Holy Spirit without receiving Christ.
예수님 안 받아들이고 성령 하나님 받는 거는
And you cannot receive Christ without receiving the Holy Spirit.
성령 하나님 없이 예수님 어떻게 받아들이니?
So these are not two separate things.
두 개 똑같은 말입니다.
This is one and the same thing.
같은 거예요.
Paul makes it very clear. Whenever you surrender to Christ, it is because you are saying yes to the Holy Spirit.
우리가 그리스도께 굴복하는 것은 우리가 성령께 우리 마음에 대한 통제권을 자발적으로 내어드리기 때문에.
So there's no such a thing as a second blessing.
두 번째 축복 없습니다.
It's always the first blessing repeated many times.
첫 번째 축복이 계속 반복되는 거예요.
Every time you surrender to Christ, you receive the Holy Spirit.
예수님께 굴복하면 성령이 오십니다.
Every time you want to surrender to Christ, it's because the Holy Spirit is active in your life.
성령 하나님께 굴복하고 싶어. 성령 하나님이 일하시기 때문이죠.
So in general, the evidence of the Spirit in your life is not by powerful miracles. It is not by the supernatural, such as speaking in tongues or doing miracles.
성령께서 계시다는 것은 기적을 통해서만이 항상 그런 건 아닙니다.
The Bible teaches that the evidence of the Spirit in your life is the fruit.
열매.
The fruit of the Spirit and the gifts of the Spirit. That is the evidence that the Spirit is working in your life.
성령이 함께하고 계시다는 증거는 우리가 맺는 열매와 우리가 하는 은사.
The Spirit reveals Jesus and His Spirit of love and self-sacrifice.
예수님의 사랑과 자희생의 정신이 성경에 말하는 성령의 증거입니다.
The gifts reveal the fact that God is at work in you, so that you can be at work on behalf of others.
하나님의 교회를 살리기 위해 다른 사람들을 위해서 봉사하고 은사, 그게 성령께서 일하시는 증거입니다.
Many years ago, I met somebody who became a good friend of mine.
제 친구가 있어요.
His name was Mike.
마이크인데.
And he was a member of my church.
제 교인이었습니다.
He was only a few years older than I was.
같은 교회 교인인데 저보다 나이 좀 많고.
He was a chemical engineer who was an agnostic.
화학공학 기술자인데 하나님 안 믿어요.
But he had a series of negative things happening in his life.
되게 문제가 많았어.
He got divorced. He lost a lot of the accounts. He started losing money.
이혼하고 돈 없고 다 뺏기고.
He wanted to be rich. He wanted power and glory.
돈 많이 벌고 싶고 능력 있고 싶었는데.
Even though he was an engineer, you know, they tend to be quiet type people.
기술자들 보통 조용하잖아요.
But God led him to a breakdown basically.
그때 하나님께서 한 그 사람들을 완전히
And he was invited to attend a Seventh-day Adventist revelation seminar.
겸손하게 만들고 싶었는데 그때 계시록 세미나에 옵니다.
He decided to go.
갔습니다.
And from the first night, he was hooked.
첫 번째 날 꽂혔어요.
And the Holy Spirit began to talk with him and began to lead him.
성령께서 말씀하시고 인도하십니다.
He was one of the first ones making the decision to follow God and to join the church.
가장 먼저 결정했습니다. 하나님 따라.
And he was very much like Paul, the kind of guy that once he decided something, he was going to stick to that and never look back.
한번 착수하니까 쭉 갑니다.
Everything he read from the Bible, he immediately put to practice.
성경에서 배운 거 바로 실천합니다.
And then he was introduced to the spirit of prophecy.
예언의 신.
And whatever he read from Ellen White, he put to practice.
읽고 실천합니다.
He did not conceive on saying, "Oh, that's interesting," and just think about it.
재밌네. 그냥 생각할 거리로만 남기는 것이 아니라.
He was an actions man. He immediately obeyed.
바로 행했습니다.
When he was getting ready to be baptized, he got very sick.
근데 침례 받을 때 막 갑자기 아픈 거예요.
High fever.
막 열나고.
And the church members say, "Oh, don't worry about it. We can baptize you 2 weeks later."
2주 후에 할게. 2주 후에.
And he says, "Don't tell me that."
그러지 마.
I've made the most important decision.
가장 중요한 결정 내렸는데 내가.
How could I postpone it?
내가 어떻게 미루니?
I need to act on it right now.
지금 해야 돼.
And he dragged himself to the church with a 105 fever to get himself baptized.
그래서 막 열이 나는데도 침례하러 갔어요.
105, what is that? Like 40?
40?
I don't know.
한 40도 정도, 굉장히 높은 열.
38, 40? Something like that. Anyway, it's high fever. as soon as he came back from the water, back up from the water in his baptism, he was instantly healed.
물에서 나오니까 성령 하나님께서
the fever left him, the discomfort left him, and he was fine.
열병이 달아나고 갑자기 확 나왔어요 몸이.
He has had many. Miracles like that happen in his life.
기적이 굉장히 많이 일어났어요 그 삶에서.
One time, well, after a few years of being an Adventist, he read and underlined carefully the book Counsels on Diets and Foods from Ellen White.
교인 되고 나서 그 음식물에 관한 권면을 막 보는 거예요. 이언의 신.
And he took it to heart.
실천하고.
If you've ever read that book, it is full of counsel.
진짜 배울 거 많아요.
I mean, one line, two line counsels, boom, 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 one after another.
엄청 많아요.
Without much context, and so,
맥락도 없이.
You know, you have like 100 lifetimes of teaching in that single book.
그 책 하나에 인생 100개 살아도 못 배울 교훈들이 많아요.
So he decided, he realized that the best diet was the original diet.
에덴 동산 돌아가야 되겠다.
And what's the original diet?
그 식생활로.
Nuts and seeds and fruit.
견과류 먹고 과일 먹고 채소 먹고.
You can read about it in Genesis 1.
창세기 1장에 나오죠.
Vegetables were added after sin.
채소는 나중에 나왔죠.
For the healing of the nations, the leaves are for the healing of the nations, healing of people.
사람들을 고치려고.
So he took a couple of years to devise a careful diet, where he would eat certain grains on certain days, and some more often than others.
어떤 날은 곡식을 더 많이 먹고.
He consulted with scientists. He consulted with physicians.
과학자들.
And then he would get fruit. 의사. He lived in California where there is a lot of fruit.
의사 그리고 이제 과일 먹고. 캘리포니아 살았으니까 많아요.
And that was his food.
그걸 많이 먹었어요.
And when I met him, he had that diet.
그거를 아직도 먹고
Very simple diet.
아주 간단.
He would buy grains. Bulk in big 50-pound bags.
곡식을 50파운드 사가지고는.
And most of the fruit he got was for free because he had fruit trees in his yard and the neighbors also had them.
자기가 키우고 이웃 거 막 먹었어요 공짜로 그냥.
So you know how much money he spent? This is 25 years ago.
25년 전에 돈을 얼마나 썼냐면.
How much money he spent on food?
음식에.
He spent about $10 a month on food.
한 달에 $10 썼습니다. 우리나라 만 원.
Can you believe it?
엄청나죠.
About 27 cents a day.
25센트야 하루에. 250원.
You say, wow. And he could survive that way.
어떻게 그렇게 했을까?
You better believe it.
진짜 그렇게.
He did exercise.
운동하고.
He did weights. He was strong as an ox.
진짜 셌어요.
He had glasses, and after a few years, he tossed them away because his
안경도.
eyesight got better.
시력도 좋아지고.
Where have you heard of that?
들어본 적 있었어요.
That your eyes get actually reverse. You know, they get better.
시력이 좋아졌어요. 시력이.
One time, he broke his clavicle. He fell broke his clavicle.
여기가 부러졌는데.
And part of the bone was sticking out.
쇄골이 막.
He went home instead of. Calling 911, he went home and prayed.
구급차 안 가고 그냥 기도했습니다.
Because he by now is a serious man of prayer.
이제 기도를 엄청 심각하게 합니다.
And he said, God, this really hurts.
하나님 아파요.
But if you want me to understand some of what you have heard for me, I'm okay to experience this pain.
하나님 고통 괜찮으니까 저 교훈 가르쳐 주세요.
But if you want to take it away, you can.
근데 제해 주시려면 제해 주세요.
As soon as he finished praying,
기도 끝나니까
the pain went away.
고통이 없어졌어요.
But the bone was still sticking out there.
뼈는 이렇게 나와 있었어요.
Now this is, I know this sounds unreal, but I'm telling you the truth.
비현실적인 것 같지만 사실입니다.
He kept working in his home for a couple of hours with the bone sticking out.
그래서 뼈 튀어나온 상태로 더 일했어요 몇 시간 동안.
And then it dawned on him he needed to set that bone.
이제 내가 이거 좀 뭐 어떻게
so
해야 돼서
So he walked into this is in Sacramento, California. He walked into a clinic.
사크라멘토 캘리포니아 그 의사한테 갑니다.
And with a big smile.
웃으면서.
And with a bone sticking out.
이게 뼈 튀어나왔어요.
And so the medical people immediately try to rush in, you know, and the doctor says, "What are you on?"
뭐 이게 뭐예요? 이게 왜 뭐예요? 그 병원 사람들이.
The doctor meant is, "What kind of powerful drug must you be on that you're so happy with a bone sticking out?"
아니 무슨 마약을 했길래 이거 어떻게 된 거 이게?
And he said, typical of Mike, he said, I'm on Jesus.
예수님 마약.
And he was. He actually meant that.
진짜 느꼈습니다.
And of course the doctor said, yeah, yeah, whatever.
뭐래.
The doctor set the bone and told them, make sure you get it, you eat a lot of calcium, food
그래서,
with calcium.
그래서 뼈 고치고 이제 칼슘 많이 먹어야 돼.
You know, like cheese and milk and all of that.
치즈, 우유.
And of course, Mike had long forsaking all that type of food.
옛날에 그거 다 이제 안 먹기로 했죠.
And he just said yes and decided to eat a lot of kiwi.
그래, 저는 키위를 많이 먹을게요.
Because kiwi is high on calcium.
칼슘 많아요, 키위.
And there were plenty of kiwi out there.
키위 많으니까 거기.
And the doctor said, don't move. You know, it'll take 6 weeks to heal. It is a bad break.
6주 동안
but
걸려요.
But come
맞는데.
And see me in 4 weeks. I want to see progress.
4주 후에 오세요. 찾으러 볼 테니까.
But after 2 days of having his arm like this, he said, why should I have to live this way?
왜 내가 이렇게 살아야 되지? 팔 이렇게 됐는데.
And he decided to go swimming.
의사 말 안 듣고 수영을 갑니다.
He said, you know, I just don't see... And I asked him, you know, he was telling me this story, and I asked him, Mike, he started swimming, crawling, you know, with
수영 막 이렇게 합니다.
Going this way. And I said, Mike, didn't that bother you? Weren't you hurting when you tried to swim like that?
안 아파, 수영하는데?
He says, no, it really didn't bother me. I could feel things moving in there.
뭔가 이제 움직이는데 뭐 그냥 괜찮아.
But it was fine, he said.
괜찮던데?
Well, the guy is so healthy
엄청 건강합니다.
That in 3 weeks the whole bone was healed.
3주 후에 다 났어요.
And the doctor said 6 weeks.
의사는 6주.
And so he went back to the clinic after 3 weeks.
그러니까 3주 후에 그냥 가니까 의사가.
And the doctor couldn't believe his eyes.
도대체 믿을 수가 없는 거예요.
And he took another X-ray and he checked and he told me he kept pounding on my bone as almost as if he was mad that. But it was healed so fast.
엑스레이 찍고 막 화난 듯이 막 때리더래요 여기를. 어떻게 된 거야?
And so he says, what did you do?
어떻게 한 거 도대체?
I've never seen a bone like this heal so fast.
아니 무슨 뼈가 이렇게 빨리 나?
And he just smiled and says, well, I just ate a lot of kiwi.
키위 많이 먹었어요.
That's Mike. Mike gave 90% of his income. Away.
90%의 소득을
Some of us some people I know bellyache
헌금.
to give away 10%.
10%도 지금 아까운 사람들이 많은데.
Tithe. He only kept a tithe.
10%만 자기가 가지고.
And he gave away everything else.
90% 교회에 하나님께.
One time he told me he was invited by a general conference a big banquet.
그래서 대총회 연회장에 초대받았는데.
You understand Mike is a very You know, he's a humble guy. You would, if you saw him, you would never think he was, you know, he dresses very simply. You would never know he's somebody high up there.
보면은 그 지위 높은 사람인지 모를 거 굉장히 겸손하고
단순하게 보여. They invited him because they thought he was some rich man because he kept giving all this money.
그래서 대충해서 봤을 때 아, 이 사람 진짜 많은 것 같아. 그래가지고 대충해서 초대했어요.
But he lives by faith. He
믿음으로 살아요.
He just trusts in God.
하나님 신뢰하고.
And God provides for him.
하나님이 공급하십니다.
And time and time again, for instance, one time, we were at a board meeting in the church.
직원회 하는데 교회에서.
And somebody brought us a letter while we were meeting.
직원회 하고 있는데 누가 편지를 가져와요.
And the letter was from a member who was requesting to be dropped. His membership to be dropped from the church.
저 교회 그 명단에서 지워주세요. 교회 안 다녀요.
And the letter explained that he had come to believe the church was Babylon.
교회는 바벨론이라고 믿는 사람이 있어요.
We knew that he was meeting with a fringe group in the city.
프랑스 사람들, 도시에 있는 사람들을 만나고 있어요.
Who are anti-Adventist church?
교회 진짜 싫어하는, 재림교회 싫어하는 사람.
And we recognized he had been deceived.
아, 이 사람 속았구나.
And a number of us, it really touched us because he was a good man, but he was just deceived.
진짜 착한 사람이었는데 어떻게 이렇게 속았을까?
And we didn't know what to do.
어떻게 해야 될지 몰랐어요.
And Mike said, Pastor, is it okay if I visit him?
저 그 사람한테 가보고 싶어요. 방문.
And I said, of course, for any of us, you know, if we need to pray for this man and we need to show him that we care about him and ask God to help us, help him.
맞아요. 우리가 도와줘야 돼요. 기도해줘야 되고 도와줘야 돼요. 그 사람.
So he visited with him.
그 사람 집에 갑니다.
Every day.
매일.
Would you visit somebody every day?
누군가를 맨날 방문할 수 있으세요?
Somebody who is in danger.
위험에 처한 사람.
Spiritual danger. Would you visit him every day?
영적인 위험. 매일.
He visited him every day.
매일 갔습니다. 그 사람 집에.
Some visits were as short as 20 minutes.
20분이.
Some visits were as long as 3 or 4 hours.
어떤 날은 3-4시간.
And he simply asked God to use him.
하나님 저를 사용해주세요.
After 6 weeks,
6주 후,
after 6 weeks,
6주 후,
of visiting this brother every day,
매일 6주 동안 가다가,
both of them came one Sabbath to church.
같이 안식에 들어오는 교회로,
arm on arm,
이렇게 팔 잡고,
and the brother restored, completely restored, saying, "I've made a mistake. I now understand what that this is God's church."
그 속은 사람이 아 여기 하나님의 교회예요.
But what did it take?
회복되었습니다.
It take a visit every single day for 6 weeks.
매일 6주 동안 방문한 사람의 노력으로.
Who has the time to do that?
믿음으로.
For Mike, it didn't matter whether he had time or not.
그 시간을 투자했어요.
It needed to be done.
이거 해야 돼.
And God would provide, would work out his schedule.
하나님이 하실 거야.
And that's the kind of a guy he was.
굉장히 믿음이 좋은 사람.
You see that the evidence of the Holy Spirit in his life.
하나 성령께서 일하시는 그 증거입니다.
And it was very, very clear, very patent.
굉장히 분명하죠.
One last story about him.
하나 더 얘기하겠습니다. 그분에 대해서.
Towards the end of our ministry in that church.
제가 거기서 사역하기 거의 끝날 때쯤.
We noticed that several couples were in trouble.
이제
I was counseling one of the wives who was coming every week to talk with me about those problems.
한 부인이 저한테 와가지고 계속 상담을 하는데.
And I was acquainted with another case that was in trouble.
또 이제 어떤 이제 다른 문제가 또 있어요.
Then we left. We had to leave to teach, to start teaching in Tennessee.
또 테네시로 이제 가르치러 갔어요, 제가.
A year later we came back.
거기 떠났다가 이제
And we heard the rest of the story. What happened to these people?
1년 이따 다시 지역에 왔는데
When Mike heard that one husband had been kicked out of his house, he invited him to stay with him in his own house.
남편이 쫓겨나 가지고 집에서 마이크가 그 사람 데려다가 같이 살았어요.
He had a 4-bedroom house.
방 4개.
So he could spare 3 bedrooms.
세 개 이제 쓸 수 있죠.
He says come and live with me.
나랑 살자.
I won't charge you any rent.
공짜야.
And I'll share my food with you if you want it.
밥 줄게.
You can bring your food if you want it.
네 먹고 싶은 거 가져와.
And I'm going to pray with you.
기도할 거 너랑.
For your marriage.
네 결혼을 위해서 결혼 생활.
A few weeks later, a second husband was kicked out of the house.
다른 남편이 또 쫓겨납니다.
And he invited him to come into the house. 또 그
남편이 이제 두 명이.
And then a third husband.
또 다른 남자가 또
left the house.
또 이제 가출합니다.
And he invited him to come into his own house.
남자 세 명이 거기서 살게 됩니다.
And then a fourth man.
이제 네 명. 네 번째.
And he invited him also to come to his house.
네 번째 남자도 거기
Now how many bedrooms does the house have?
침실 몇 개라고 그랬죠?
Four bedrooms. He probably uses one, right?
자기가 쓰던 것.
So what happened when he invited the fourth man to come into his house?
네 명째였을 때 어떻게 했을까요?
He gave up his own bedroom.
자기 거 줬어요.
And rented a little apartment for him to live in while he kept the four men in his house.
그래서 네 명이 다른 사람들이 자기 집에 살고 자기는 다른 데 가가지고 월세 냈어요.
For free.
그 사람들 다 공짜고 자기는 돈 내고.
When I heard Mike, when I heard that story, I asked Mike, "What were your intentions? What were you hoping to do?"
너 왜 그렇게 했니? 물어봤어요. 제가.
And he says, "My plan was to pray these men back into the arms of their wives." That's a quote, a direct quote.
기도해가지고 그 사람들 아내한테 다시 돌려주는 거야.
Now I've been a pastor for 36, 37 years.
36년, 37년 목사 했는데.
And let me tell you, when people separate, it's because a lot of bad stuff has happened in between.
부부가 이별하는 거는 과거에 굉장히 안 좋은 과거가 있기 때문이죠.
In other words, it's very difficult for couples to get reunited after that.
엄청 안 좋은 일이 있은 다음에 다시 합치는 거 진짜 어려워요.
A year later, when we came back to visit that church.
다시 그 교회 지역에 방문했는데
All four of those marriages were healed.
그 네 가정이 다 회복됐습니다.
I was telling this story a few years ago in Alaska.
알래스카에서 얘기하니까
at a camp meeting.
캠프 미팅에서
And a man sitting in the back raised his hand and stood up.
장막공에서 그 얘기를 제가 하니까 남자가 일어나요.
He yelled from the back and he says, "What the pastor says is true."
목사님 말 맞아요.
And he says, "I was one of those four men."
제가 그 네 명 중에 한 명이에요.
The evidence of the Spirit is not so much in speaking in tongues or in something supernatural.
성령께서 함께 하신다는 증거는 방언, 기적 이런 게 아닙니다.
The Spirit is in things of this nature.
성령 하나님의 그
The evidence that God Himself
하나님 자신
indwells us.
우리 안에 거하시는 거죠.
Turn to Colossians chapter 1. Would you please, if you have your phones or your Bibles with you.
골로새서 1장 19절에서 27절.
We'll try to understand it from this verse perspective. I'll just read it in English while Jawa gets his Bible. Verse 19. For it was the Father's good pleasure for all the fullness to dwell in him. And through him to reconcile all things to himself, having made peace through the blood of his cross, through him, I say, whether things on earth or things in heaven. And although you were formerly alienated and hostile in mind, engaged in evil deeds, yet he has now, why did he say that? Because the members of the Galatian churches were all Gentiles. They were pagans. And they were used to doing some very bad stuff before they became Christians.
고로새인들이 다 이방인들이었기 때문에 과거가 굉장히 악했어요.
In verse 22, and then he'll read the whole thing. Yet he has now reconciled you in his fleshly blood through death in order to present you before him holy and blameless and beyond reproach. If indeed you continue in the faith firmly established and steadfast and not moved away by the hope of the gospel that you have heard, which was proclaimed in all creation under heaven, and of which I, Paul, was made a minister. Verse 24. Now I rejoice in my... Before reading that, why don't you read 19 to 23, and then I'll read the rest.
아버지께서는 모든 충만으로 예수 안에 거하게 하시고 그 십자가의 피로 화평을 이루사 만물고 땅에 있는 것들이나 하늘에 있는 것들을 그로 말미암아 자기와 화목케 되기를 기뻐하심이라 전에 악한 행실로 멀리 떠나 마음으로 원수가 되었던 너희를 이제는 그의 육체의 죽음으로 말미암아 화목케 하사 너희를 거룩하고 힘없고 책망할 것이 없는 자로 그 앞에 세우고자 하셨으니 만일 너희가 믿음에 거하고 터 위에 굳게 서서 너희 입술은 바 복음의 소망에서 흔들리지 아니하면 그리하리라 이 복음은 천하 만민에게 전파된 바요 나 바울은 이 복음의 일꾼이 되었노라 내가 이제 너희를 위하여 받는 괴로움을 기뻐하고 그리스도의 남은 고난을 그의 몸된 교회를 위하여 내 육체에 채우노라.
Verse 24. Now I rejoice in my sufferings for you.
기뻐한다. 내가 기뻐한다.
Think about that.
생각해 보세요.
Who can say that?
고난하는데 기뻐요.
Now that sounds like somebody like Mike.
마이크 같죠?
Somebody who is willing to be spent on behalf of somebody else.
자기 자신을 내어 주는 거예요. 다른 사람을 위해서.
And rejoices in it's glad.
기뻐하는 거예요.
For whatever price he has to pay so that others can benefit.
그 어떤 희생도 상관없어요. 그 사람이 다른 사람이 잘 될 수만 있다면.
So let me read 24 to 27.
24-26.
Now I rejoice in my sufferings for your sake, and in my flesh I do my share on behalf of his body, which is the church, in filling up what is lacking in Christ's afflictions. Of this church I was made a minister, according to the stewardship from God bestowed on me for your benefit, so that I might fully carry out the preaching of the word of God, that is, the mystery which has been hidden from past ages and generations, but has now been manifested to his saints, to whom God willed to make known what is the riches of the glory of this mystery among the Gentiles, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory.
영광의 소망. 내가 이제 너희를 위하여 받는 괴로움을 기뻐하고 그리스도의 남은 고난을 그의 몸된 교회를 위하여 내 육체에 채우노라. 내가 교회에 일군된 것과 하나님이 너희를 위하여 내게 주신 경륜을 따라 하나님의 말씀을 이루려 함이니라. 이 비밀은 만세와 만대로부터 오므로 감추었던 것인데 이제는 그의 성도들에게 나타났고 하나님이 그들로 하여금 그 비밀의 영광이 이방인 가운데 어떻게 풍성한 것을 알게 하려 하심이라. 이 비밀은 너희 안에 계신 그리스도시니 곧 영광의 소망이니라.
So he speaks about this mystery. What mystery? The fact that pagans can be saved.
이방인도 구원받을 수 있어.
The fact that God is able to save to the uttermost.
하나님은 왕창 구원하실 수 있어.
The fact that God can change every situation which appears to be irreversible.
진짜 말도 안 되는 상황을 구원할 수 있어.
This is that great mystery.
비밀이죠.
And that happens when Christ is in you.
놀라운 비밀, 너 안에 있는 그리스도.
Now, let's visualize this.
한번 시각화시켜
Christ in you.
예수님이 내 마음에.
All right? Visualize Christ in you.
한번 생각해 보세요.
That's what he's saying.
생각해 보세요.
Now that is something that you find that teaching you find it all over the New Testament.
신약 전반에 걸쳐서 있는 얘기입니다.
In Galatians 2:20, I have been crucified with Christ and it is no longer I who live but Christ lives in me.
내가 그리스도와 함께 십자가에 못 박혔나니 그런즉 이제는 내가 사는 것이 아니요 오직 내 안에 그리스도께서 사시는 것이라. 갈라디아 2장 20절.
It's not me. It's Christ who lives in me.
내가 아니라 그리스도 내 안에.
And the life which I now live in the flesh I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and delivered himself up for me.
이제 내가 육체 가운데 사는 것은 나를 사랑하사 나를 위하여 자기 자신을 버리신 하나님의 아들을 믿는 믿음 안에서 사는 것이라. 갈라디아 2장 20절.
To the Colossians he said something similar.
골로새서
Set your mind on the things above, for you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God.
위의 것을 생각하고 있는 너희가 죽었고 너희 생명이 그리스도와 함께 하나님 안에 감추어졌습니다.
When Christ, who is our life, is revealed, then you also will be revealed with Him in glory.
우리의 생명이신 그리스도께서 나타나실 그때에 너희도 그와 함께 영광 중에 나타나리라.
In other words, when Jesus comes, when he's revealed, second coming,
예수님이 오실 때, 재림 때, 나타나실 때,
he will find a match.
똑같은 걸 볼 거예요.
He will find that you reflect who he is.
예수님의 영광을 반사하는 우리.
That's what he's saying.
그게 요지입니다.
Or in Romans chapter 8.
로마서.
For the law of the spirit of life in Christ Jesus has made me free from the law of sin and death.
그리스도 이는 그리스도 예수 안에 있는 생명의 성령의 법이 죄와 사망의 법에서 너를 해방하였습니다.
Or in Philippians, to the Philippians he says, for to me to live is Christ and to die is gain.
이는 내게 사는 것이 그리스도니 죽는 것도 유익함이라.
He was not talking about physical death. He's talking about self-death.
자기 자신이 죽는 거 육체적으로 죽는 게 아니라.
The gain is when I lay down my selfishness, my willfulness, my self.
내 이기심 자존심 내 이기심 자존심 버리면 그리스도가 오십니다.
Even though we may not feel alive in Christ, we may count it to be so.
그리스도 안에 한 채로 거하는 것 같은 느낌이 안 들어도 믿음으로 그렇게 해주시는 하나님의 약속을 주장해야 한다.
Oh, I don't know if Christ lives in me. I don't feel different.
느낌이 없어.
But the Bible doesn't teach that you need to feel something before you believe it.
성경은 먼저 믿고 나중에 믿기라고 합니다.
Teaches you need to choose to believe what he says.
먼저 선택을 해라 말씀을.
Regardless of how you feel.
환경, 느낌 상관없이.
So for example, when you have a text like this, for the death that he, that Jesus died, he died to sin once for all, but the life that he lives to God.
그가 예수님이 죽으시면 죄에 대하여 단번에 죽으시며 그가 살아계시면 하나님께 대하여 살아계심이니.
This and this is yeah this is the next verse. Even so, consider yourselves to be dead to sin, but alive to God in Christ Jesus.
이와 같이 너희도 너희 자신을 죄에 대하여 죽은 자요 그리스도 예수 안에서는 하나님께 대하여는 살아있는 자로 여길지어다.
And that is in Romans 6.
로마 6장.
Now it says, consider yourselves to be dead to sin.
죄에 대하여 죽은 자로 여겨라.
Do you feel dead to sin many times?
죄에 대하여 죽은 건 느낌 나요?
Do you wake up in the morning and say, you know what? I really think that sin has no hold on me anymore.
어 이제 죄가 내 안에 없는 것 같아. 그런 느낌 드나요 아침에?
I really feel like I'm sinless right now.
어 나 죄가 없어 나는 느낌이 들어.
Do you feel that way?
느낌 드세요?
I don't feel that way.
그런 건 느낌이 안 들어.
If you're anything like me, you're painfully aware of your mistakes. You're painfully aware of your weaknesses.
여러분들의 약점, 여러분들의 그 실수한 거 다 기억나시죠?
But the Bible doesn't say think about your weaknesses.
너 자신의 약점에 대해 생각해 이런 말 없습니다.
The Bible doesn't teach focus on your mistakes.
네 실수한 거 그 집중해.
The Bible says consider yourself to be dead to sin.
죄에 죽은 걸로 여겨라.
Even though you may not be dead to sin.
그게 사실이 아니라도 그렇게 여겨라.
Think of yourself as being dead to sin.
그냥 그렇다고 여기고 생각해라고 믿어라.
And that will actually lead you to be dead to sin.
그럼 그렇게 하면 결국 그렇게 될 것이다.
What an astonishing thing.
엄청난 일이죠.
You see the fundamental difference between Christianity and every other worldview.
근본적인 차이는 기독교에
is the fact that Christians actually believe in what God says. Not in how they feel.
하나님의 말씀을 믿는 것이요 그들의 기분이 아니라.
Everybody else functions based on how they feel.
기독교인들 이외 사람들은 다 느낌으로 다 판단합니다.
Unfortunately, many Christians do too. And many times we do.
기독교인들도 그렇게 하고 우리도 그렇게 하고.
But the Bible teaches we need to live based on what God says, in spite of how we feel.
우리 느낌 상관없이 하나님의 말씀을 믿어라.
So you may not feel God in you.
내 안에 예수님 없는 것 같은데 느껴도.
But you can claim his promise. You say, I have invited Jesus to be in my life.
약속을 주장하세요. 나 예수님 초청했어 내 마음에.
I have asked him to live in me.
내 안에 계세요. 주장했어요. 기도했어요.
Then I'll believe that he is actually doing that.
그럼 나는 믿게 됩니다. 진짜 하고 계시다고.
Until it becomes more and more evident, even to you, to your eyes, to my eyes, that that is actually so.
계속 그렇게 하면 나한테도 분명해지고 다른 사람한테도 분명해지고.
So Jesus said in John 14, I am the way, the truth, and the life.
내가 곧 길이요 진리요 생명이니.
I am your life.
내가 네 생명이야.
I am the life that counts.
내 생명이야.
I am the life that can be in you that can change your life.
진짜 네 삶 바꿀 수 있어.
And he said in John 10, I am the door. If anyone enters through me, he shall be saved. I came that you might have life and you might have it abundantly.
요한복음 10장 9절 10절 내가 문이니 누구든지 나를 말미암아 들어가면 구원을 받고 내가 온 것은 양으로 생명을 얻게 하고 더 풍성히 얻게 하려는 것이다.
So not only does the Bible tell us Christ can be in us through the Holy Spirit.
성경은 성령을 통해 그분이 우리 안에 거하실 뿐 아니라
that we can be in Christ. It's interesting how
우리가 그분 안에 거할 수 있다고 말합니다.
The apostles deal with that. For example, in Ephesians chapter 1.
에베소서
The faithful are in Christ.
그리스도 안에 안에 있는 신실한 자들.
The blessed are in Christ.
그리스도 안에서 복을 받은.
We are chosen in Christ.
그리스도 안에서 택함 받고.
We are accepted in Christ.
사랑하시는 자 안에서.
In Him we have redemption.
받으신 바 받고 속량 받고.
The mystery of God's will is known in Christ.
그리스도의 비밀 그리스도 안에서 알려지고.
In Him we have an inheritance.
예수님 안에 우리가 유산이 있고 so, 기업이 있고.
You can summarize all this by saying Christ in me.
그리스도 내 안에 요약하면.
I in Christ.
내가 그리스도 안에.
That means Christ surrounds me.
예수님이 나를 둘러쌉니다.
Right? Christ is in me.
내 안에 있고.
And I am in Christ.
저는 예수님 안에 있고.
So I'm surrounded by Christ.
예수님한테
right? In
쌓여
있어.
안에 밖에.
So I am being sandwiched by Jesus.
완전 사방에 둘려서 있어.
Think of it this way.
한번 이렇게 생각해 보세요.
I am sandwiched by Jesus Christ.
꼈습니다, 예수님한테.
And that is what the apostle Paul understood, and that's why he said, "Now I rejoice in my sufferings."
나는 괴로움을 기뻐한다.
Because my sufferings have been filtered through the sandwich.
그 샌드위치에 의해서 내 고통이 정화됐어요.
Whatever I experience, whatever I get, is because he thinks that's the best thing.
아무나 와도 그게 나한테 좋은 거야. Wow. 감사합니다.
But most of us would think, you know, when we're suffering, we say, "Oh God, please spare me."
저 좀 살려주세요. 부탁 이렇게 고통이 오면 저 이거 싫어요.
Or may even complain and say, you know, 불평하고. "Why, you know, you don't you care about me?"
원망하고 왜 하나님 나 버렸어요?
Well, it is because he cares about us that sometimes we suffer.
우리를 사랑하시기 때문에 좋아하시기 때문에 우리에게 고통을 주시는 거예요.
To help us recognize something that otherwise we would not see.
고통 아니면 볼 수 없는 그 축복.
A few years ago, there was a young woman who went to one of those large camp meetings that you can still go in the United States.
한 여자분이 큰 장로봉에 갔습니다, 미국에서.
Some of these large camp meetings gather between 15 and 18,000 people on a weekend.
15,000에서 18,000명 한 장소에 모입니다.
Some of you may have been to some of them.
한번 가보셨을 거예요?
And when that happens, that's usually a large conference.
큰 합회.
And so they put all the pastors to work.
그래서 목사님들 열심히 일하고 있어요. 거기서.
To prepare the camp meeting, to lead in various groups.
준비하고 이끌고.
Various ministries.
막 사역들을 이끌고.
And one of those ministries in large camp meetings like that is the ministry of prayer and counseling.
기도하고 상담하는 일이 벌어집니다.
And this man, Frank Phillips, was. Years ago, he was one of those people helping people.
이 사람이 이제 상담을 해주고 도와주고 이랬었는데.
To listen to their troubles, to give counsel, to pray for them.
저한테 얘기해 주세요. 기도해 드리고.
And a young woman came.
한 여자가 왔어요.
And she said, "I'm having problems with my husband."
저 남편이랑 문제가 있어요.
He is not a good husband at all.
남편이 너무 이상해요.
He drinks all the time.
맨날 술 마시고.
He cannot hold a job.
일도 안 하고.
He gets fired every 2-3 weeks. He doesn't take care of the family.
가족 신경도 안 쓰고.
He doesn't concern himself with the children.
애들 신경도 안 써요.
He doesn't beat me up, but he abuses us in every other way.
뭐 때리는 건 아닌데 모든 삶에 완전히
He mostly neglects us.
너무 우리를 신경 안 써요.
And we've gone counseling. We've sought counseling for this.
막 상담 막 했는데 여기저기서 해결하려고.
He always says he's going to get better. And
어, 잘할게, 잘할게.
He gets better for 2 days and then goes back to his drinking.
똑같아요. 또 술 마시고.
And many people are telling me the best thing I should do is leave him.
사람들이 그냥 야 그냥 떠나 떠나.
And I'm
떠나.
about to do that.
어, 이렇게 진짜 하고 싶어요 지금.
Do you have any counsel for me?
저 상담 어떻게 하죠?
And the pastor listened carefully and then he asked her a question, a very important question.
듣고 질문을 합니다. 중요한 질문.
He asked her, if you had the solution,
해결책이 있다면,
if you knew something could actually fix your marriage,
진짜 뭐가 해결할 수 있다고 생각해 보세요.
Would you be willing to do whatever it takes?
한번 해볼 생각 있어요?
To have that solution.
그거 내가 알려줄 테니까 해볼 생각 있어요?
He thought for a moment.
생각해보고.
I think so. I'd like to save my marriage.
어, 하고 싶어요. 우리 결혼.
But we've tried everything.
회복시키고 싶어요. 다 해봤는데.
And then he gave her a little card with a quotation from Ellen White.
거기서 이제 카드에다가 이제 엘렌즈와 예언하신 구절이.
And he said, "Take this to your tent." She was in a tent.
거기 텐트 자고 있으니까 그거 가져가시고.
"Read it tonight. Pray about it, and let me know tomorrow what you decide."
오늘 기도해 보시고 이렇게 할 건지 안 할 건지 내일 알려주세요.
And this is the text that he gave her.
이걸 줬습니다. 이 카드를 줬습니다.
Now let's read this carefully.
읽어보세요.
Because many people, when they read this, they misunderstand what they're reading.
어떤 사람은 이거 의미를 잘 오해합니다.
It reads, "The Father's presence encircled Christ, and nothing befell him that But that which infinite love permitted for the blessing of the world.
아버지 임재가 그리스도를 두르고 있었으므로 무한한 사랑이 세상에 축복을 위하여 허락하는 것 외에는 아무것도 그분께 닥치지 않았다.
The Father's presence encircled Christ.
아버지 임재가 둘렀습니다. 예, 그리스도를.
That sandwich.
샌드위치처럼 right? 둘렀어요.
Okay. Here was his source of comfort, and it is for us. He who is imbued with the Spirit of Christ abides in Christ.
여기에 그분의 위로의 근원이 있었으면 이것은 우리를 위한 것이다.
The blow that is aimed at him falls upon the Savior who surrounds him with his presence.
이 사람을 겨냥한 강탄은 그를 당신의 임재로 두르고 있는 구제주께로 떨어지게 된다.
Ellen White is making this case. She says, "Here's Christ."
예수님.
And the Father surrounded him.
예수님, 아버지가 둘러싸고.
And nothing ever happened to him that the Father did not approve of.
아빠가 허락하는 것만 떨어집니다.
And then she turns to us and says,
우리한테,
"So it is with us."
우리도 그래.
Here we are.
이게 우리야.
And Jesus is surrounding us 예수님이, with His presence.
예수님이 이렇게 임재.
And so whatever blow comes from the enemy.
원수가 뭘 와요?
Because the blows
공격이.
come from the enemy, right?
공격이 와요. 예,
They come from Satan.
사단이.
Whatever blows come from the enemy eventually do not reach us from the enemy. They reach us from Christ.
원수가 공격을 하는 것이 우리한테 오는 게 아니라 그리스도를 통하여 온다.
Why do they reach us from Christ?
왜 그리스도를 통하여 오죠?
Imagine this microphone with a cover. You've seen the covers that microphones have.
마이크로 이거 커버 있잖아요.
If I'm shooting water to the microphone, which
물,
is not a good idea by the way.
물 쏘면 안 되는데 물 쏜다고 가정해 봅시다.
The media people are saying no, no, don't do that.
미디어 하시는 분들이 안 돼.
The argument she's making is whatever water gets to the microphone doesn't come from me anymore. It comes from the cover.
물이 오는 거는 이 커버를 통해서 가는 거야.
Because the cover could stop it, but it chooses not to, you know. Assuming the cover has will.
막기로 선택하는 거야.
The same thing happened with Jesus.
커버가.
If something affected Jesus, it's because the Father allowed that to happen.
아빠가 선택한 겁니다.
If something is affecting those who are surrounded with Christ, it's because Christ wants that to happen.
우리에게 벌어진 모든 것들은 그리스도께 선택한 거야.
It is no longer because the devil wants it to happen. Do you get it?
사단이 원해서 그런 게 아닙니다.
그리스도가 It may have originated with the devil.
사단한테 온 건 맞는데요.
But now has been filtered by Jesus himself.
예수님이 필터가 됩니다.
So, the blow that is aimed at him falls upon the Savior who surrounds him with his presence.
이 사람을 겨냥한 강탄은 그를 당신의 임재로 두르고 있는 그리스도를 통하여 온다.
Whatever comes to him comes from Christ.
그에게 닥치는 무엇이나 그리스도를 통하여 오게 된다.
It started with the devil, but now it's coming from Christ.
사단, 그리스도, 우리.
He has no need to resist evil.
악을 대항할 필요가 없고.
For Christ is his defense.
그리스도께서 우리의 방벽이 되심으로.
Nothing can touch him except by our Lord's permission.
주님께서 허락하시는 것만 우리를 건드린다.
And all things that are permitted work together for good to them that love God.
주께서 허락하시는 것은 모든 것이 합력하여 선을 이룬다.
Thoughts from the Man of Blessing, page 71. Now this is a very profound statement.
굉장히 심오한.
That most people when they read it, they don't even get what they're reading.
무슨 말인지 몰라요. 대부분의 사람들은 이걸 읽으면.
I've preached this a number of times, and there's always people who misread this.
이걸 맨날 오해합니다 사람들이.
They say, "No, some bad things happen because the devil makes them happen."
아니에요, 사단 때문에.
I agree.
맞아요.
But that doesn't mean that God has forgotten to filter them.
하나님이 중간에 안 계신 게 아니에요.
If it gets to you,
우리한테 오면,
and you're surrounded by Christ,
그리스도 안에 만약 우리가 둘러싸여 있으면, 샌드위치처럼 둘러싸여 있으면,
it no longer comes from the devil.
하나님한테 오는 게 아니에요.
For example,
예를 들면,
I'm driving on Highway 100.
자, 고속도로 100번 갑니다.
And some crazy person crashes into my car.
총행당한 사람이 와가지고 저를
and sends me to the hospital.
박아버렸어요. 제가 병원에 갔어요.
You may argue that the devil was responsible for that.
이거 사단이 한 거야.
He wanted to hurt me.
나 다치게 하려고.
But I'm surrounded by Christ.
근데 그리스도가 나를 둘러싸고 있는데.
If the devil can manage to do that,
사단이 할 수 있으면 그거를.
And Christ couldn't do anything about it.
그리스도가 아무것도 안 했다.
Who is more powerful?
누가 더 강한 거죠?
The devil or Christ?
사단 그리스도.
I am saying then that the devil was more powerful.
사단이 더 강해.
Because Christ couldn't do anything about it.
그리스도가 아무것도 안 했어.
Now the fact that he didn't do anything about it is not because he couldn't do anything about it.
그리스도가 안 했다는 것은 그리스도가 못 하기 때문에 능력이 없어서가 아닙니다.
It's because he chose not to do anything.
선택한 거예요, 하나님이.
Because he knows more than the devil.
사단보다 더 아는 게 많아요.
He is going to use something the devil wants to do for my blessing.
사단의 계략을 활용해 가지고 나를 축복합니다.
And so it may be that while I am in the hospital recovering, I have a great insight about my life that otherwise that would have never happened.
병원에서 시각이 바뀔 수도 있어요.
Or it would have taken another 10 years for me to figure out.
10년이 걸릴 수도 있는 거예요.
Or I have an encounter with somebody or something develops.
그래서 뭔가 이렇게 발전돼 가지고.
And God needed me in the hospital.
그래서 그 과정을 통해 발전돼 가지고 거기에 병원에 보냅니다. 하나님.
Wanted to hurt me.
나를 해치려고 했지만 사단.
But God says, I'm going to use what the devil has done.
사단을 내가 활용하겠어.
For his sake.
너를 위해서.
Wow.
Wow.
That's how God operates.
하나님이 그렇게 우리를 사랑하십니다.
And that's a beautiful truth that the whole world needs to know.
세상이 이걸 알 필요가 있어.
About a personal God.
굉장히 우리를
who is more than able to reverse situations and even to use the devil's methods to for your sake.
우리를 사랑하시고 상황을 역전시키고 우리를 구하시는 하나님.
God is not limited by anything.
하나님 그 어떤 것에 의해서 제안을 받지 않으십니다.
So she read it, thought about it, prayed about it. And she came back the next morning.
다음 아침에 와 가지고
and she said, "Pastor, I'm willing to do this."
저 이거 할게요.
"I'm willing to accept my husband, my no good husband."
제
my drinking, neglectful, lazy husband.
게으르고 술 먹고 진짜 친구 없는 이 사람.
As if coming from Jesus' hand.
그 사람을 예수님의 손이라고 생각하고 제가 해볼게요.
So she's no longer going to be complaining to God about her husband.
이제 불평 안 할 겁니다. 하나님이 주는 거니까.
She's going to say thank you, Jesus, for my husband.
감사합니다.
Because Jesus gave her the husband, that
bad
husband.
남편을 저에게 주셨네요.
Now, how do you say? Oh, how do you do that?
어떻게?
Well, you read in 1 Thessalonians 5 that says, you know. Always rejoice and give thanks on everything.
모든 것에 감사하고.
God doesn't say you need to feel thankful. God says just do it.
느낌과 상관없이 그냥 기뻐해라 무조건.
And see what happens.
한번 보자 그렇게 하면.
Admittedly, this was not easy to do.
당연히 안
Because there were many days when she wanted to blame God for that husband.
왜냐면 남편을
blame the husband.
남편이랑 하나님 진짜 불평하고 싶은 생각이 있었어. 진짜 짜증나고.
Or get depressed.
진짜 막 우울해질 수도 있었겠죠.
So she had to spend quite a bit of time on her knees every morning until
엄청 했습니다,
she surrendered it and said, "Jesus, I'm going to accept this husband."
이렇게 굴복하고 하나님 제 남편입니다.
As something that you are allowing me to experience.
하나님이 그거 허락하신 거죠.
A year later, she came back to camp meeting.
몇 년 후 장막봉에 옵니다.
I forgot to tell you, she had two children.
그 까먹고 얘기 안 했는데 애가 두 명 있었어요.
A little girl and then a young little boy.
여자 남자.
When she came back, the pastor recognized her.
목사님, 저 여자네.
And said, "Sister, I remember you from last year."
작년에 봤는데.
What happened to you? Your I knew that your marriage was in trouble.
1년 동안 결혼 생활 어떻게 됐어요?
Are you still married?
아직도 결혼 이어지고 있습니까?
I said, "Pastor."
목사님.
You wouldn't believe the story.
진짜 못 믿으실 거예요.
Let's sit down. So she said every day she labored to accept her husband as something that didn't come from the devil, but came from God.
하나님한테 온 남편이라고.
Even though that husband was so bad.
항상 열심히 받아들였어 믿음으로. 아무리 남편 짜증나게 해도.
She said the first 3 months of doing this was
첫 세 달.
Hell on earth.
진짜 지옥 같았어.
It was terrible.
진짜 싫었어요.
My husband got worse.
뭐 남편이 완전 더 이상하게 됐어.
And I thought it was impossible to get worse.
이거 진짜 불가능한. 이거 어떻게 더 나빠지냐 어떻게?
And I spent many hours on my knees.
진짜 많이 기도했습니다.
Spending time with God in order to accept this as coming from Him.
굴복하고 받아들이려고 말씀 보고 기도하고.
And then after 3 months,
세 달 후,
things change overnight.
하룻밤 사이에 갑자기 다 바뀌었어요.
He said one day, "I'm done with drinking."
나 이제 술 안 마셔.
The next day he got a job and he held on to it.
이제 일을 하더니 이제 계속 하는 거예요, 일을 안
잘리고. And he became responsible.
진짜 책임감 있게 되고.
And he started helping me around the house.
갑자기 집안일 도와주고.
And he would clean the house and he started doing the dishes.
집안일하고 청소하고 빨래하고.
And he would be careful with the children and take them to play and go to the park.
애들이랑 놀고 공원 데려가고.
And spend time with them and spend time with me.
애들이랑 놀고 나랑도 시간 보내.
I got a brand new husband.
와, 남편이 완전 바뀌었습니다.
It was much better than when we were dating together.
와, 데이트할 때보다 더 좋게 변했어요. 완전
every night, she said, every night he would take time just to spend with me.
매일 밤 저랑 시간 보내요.
After we put the kids to bed,
애들 재우고,
he would take me on a walk.
이제 같이 산책 가고,
or he would take me to get an ice cream.
아이스크림 사러 가고,
or he would take me on a ride.
이제 뭐 같이 뭐 차 태워주고.
In the church, there are many faithful members. Women whose husbands are good husbands.
교회에 진짜 좋은 남편들 많은데.
And those men do not do that.
그 남편들도 나의 남편처럼 안 잘해줘요.
But my husband became that kind of a man.
내 남편이 그 사람들보다 훨씬 잘해주는 남편이었어요.
But a few months later, something happened.
몇 달 후.
We were on one of our rides together.
이제 어디 차 타러 가고 있는데 차 타고.
His mother was watching our children at home.
남편 엄마가 저희 시어머니가 애들
there was a little girl and there was a little boy of 11
돌보고 있었는데
almost a year
이제 한 살짜리 애가 있었어요.
He was in the crib
11살
and grandmother fell asleep.
엄마가 이제 할머니가 자고 있는 시어머니가 자고 있는데
and the little boy managed to get out of the crib all by himself.
그 한 살짜리가 거기서 이렇게 일어난 거예요. 그
and crawled all the way to the bathroom.
이제 갔습니다. 화장실 혼자.
And got a hold of grandmother's medicines.
그러니까 할머니 그 시어머니 그
What
약을.
What a few little bottles for this, for blood pressure, for all kinds of things.
그래서 그걸 이제 먹습니다. 이렇게.
And those little bottles were all open.
그게 다 열려 있었어요.
And he brought them back and he started swallowing every one of those pills.
그 약을 다 삼켰습니다.
When grandmother woke up from her nap, she was just sitting in a chair.
이제 의자 딱 일어나 보니까 이제 일어나서 앉으니까.
There was her grandson, surrounded by empty bottles,
비어 있고 병은
comatose on the floor.
그래서 거기 바닥에 놓고.
Can you imagine?
코마?
Comatose.
그래서 완전히 이렇게 정신 나가가지고.
When the parents came back, they immediately recognized what the problem was when they saw the empty bottles of medicine.
부모님이 보니까 아 병 때문에 그랬구나, 약 때문에 그랬구나.
The grandmother had woken up before, but she was so much in shock she couldn't move.
시어머니가 너무 놀라가지고 뭐 어떻게 할 줄을 몰랐어요.
She couldn't scream.
소리 지르도 못하겠어요.
She couldn't ask for help. She was literally paralyzed.
도움도 요청 못하겠고 완전히 그냥 마비 됐습니다.
They took the little boy and rushed him to the hospital.
이제 애 데리고 이제 병원 갑니다.
In an hour after they got there, he died.
한 시간 후 죽었습니다.
Now, what the devil wants
사단이 원하는 것
is for us to conclude that's what you get for trusting God.
하나님이 신뢰하니까 내가 너한테 이렇게 준 거야.
I'm going to show you I can really hurt you.
내가 너를 그냥 완전히 망가뜨려 주겠어.
And that was the conclusion. By that father and the conclusion by the in-laws.
그래서 이제 시어머니 시할아버지들이 장모님 장모님
the father disappeared.
아빠도 그렇게 생각하고.
The in-laws disappeared. Can you imagine a grandmother
할머니가
living with the guilt of being responsible for the death of her
자기 손자
little grandson.
죽인 거나 다름없죠.
Because of her neglect.
자기가 잘못해 가지고.
So the woman got discouraged.
여자가 너무 실망을 했어요.
And she said, "How can I accept this as coming from God's hand?"
이것도 하나님의 손에서 온 건가요?
And everybody in the church, nobody really helped.
교인들 아무도 안 도와줍니다.
Because they kept saying, "Oh, God have really changed your husband. Look at what the devil has done."
네 남편은 변했어 하나님 때문에. 근데 네 애는 어떻게 된 거니?
So it was all, you know, all pointed. She kept thinking about what the devil had done.
이제 사단이 한 걸 계속 생각합니다. 사단이 한 걸. 사단이
This went on for about 3 weeks.
3주 후. 3주 동안 계속 이렇게
One day she saw a lady from the church come to her house, pull up, you know, in front of her house.
그 교인이 여자가 한 명이 방문을 했는데.
And as she went towards the door to open the door,
문을 여니까.
The Holy Spirit spoke to her mind.
성령께서 말씀하시기를 문을 열려 그러니까.
And the Holy Spirit said,
성령께서.
Didn't you promise me you would accept everything as coming from my hand?
모든 것이 내 손에서 온다고 내가 약속하지 않았니? 네가 약속하지 않았니?
And before she opened the door, she says, "Yes, Lord, I did promise you." 그 엄마가
문을 열기 전에.
But I have not been willing to accept the death of my child as coming from your hand.
근데 내 아이 죽은 거는 하나님이 준 거라고 생각하고 싶지 않았어요.
Please forgive me.
용서해 주세요.
Please help me know how to trust you.
어떻게 하나님을 신뢰할 수 있는지 알려주세요.
So she opened the door.
문 열고.
And before the lady said anything, she put her hand up and said, "Please don't say anything."
그래서 그 방문한 여자가 말하죠.
Because she knew that if the lady said, "Oh, I'm so sorry," then she would think about what the devil had done.
그래서 방문한 사람한테 아무 얘기 하지 마세요. 저 동정하지 마세요.
And she said, "Some months ago, I made a promise to Jesus that I would accept everything that happened to me as coming from His hand."
몇 달 전에 저는 하나님이랑 이미 약속했어요. 모든 것 안 좋은 것까지 하나님한테 오는 거다.
But this has been too difficult for me to accept.
이것은 너무 받아들이기 힘들더라고요.
So help me, kneel down with me, and help me pray that I may accept this, even this, as coming from Jesus.
기도해 주세요. 받아들일 수 있게.
Well, the husband came back.
남편 돌아와서.
And he said, "Wife, you're a remarkable woman."
아 정말 대단하신
분이죠. Said to his wife.
대단합니다.
It is obvious that you know God in a way that I've not known anybody know God.
하나님을 너처럼 아는 사람이 난 본 적이 없어.
And I don't know God.
난 하나님 몰라.
And I want to know God the way you know God.
너처럼 내가 하나님 알고 싶어. 너처럼.
And as a result of that, he was led to surrender his life to Christ and baptized.
그 남편도 이제 그것 때문에 침례를 받고 하나님을 믿게 되었어요.
The in-laws came back.
이제 장인장모 이제 시어머니.
And they said, many years ago, we became Seventh-day Adventists.
옛날에 수년 전에 우리 안식일 교인이었어.
We never told you this.
얘기는 안 했는데.
Because shortly after we left the church and we left God.
왜냐면 우리가 침례 받고 또 떠났거든.
And when our son was born, we did not raise him to honor God.
내가 우리가 애를 낳아가지고 하나님의 방법으로 기르지 않았어.
And that's why you have had such a bad husband.
그래서 그게 바로 그게 남편이 왜 이렇게 이상해.
But we have seen how God really is at work in you.
와 하나님이 네 안에 일하시는구나.
And we want to know the God that you know.
네가 섬기는 하나님 나도 알고 싶어.
And we want to trust in the God that you trust.
네가 신뢰하는 그 하나님 내가 알고 싶어.
And so the in-laws too became Adventists and became they were rebaptized and they followed Jesus.
시어머니 시할아버지 다 같이 침례 받았습니다.
So she finished by telling the pastor and said, "Pastor, I still do not know why my little boy died.
제 아들이 죽었는지 모르겠지만.
But I do know that Jesus had even that under control."
하지만 예수님께서 그것도 간섭하고 계셨어요.
He allowed it for a reason that he will let me know someday.
이제 알려주실 거예요, 나중에.
But I do know this.
지금 이건 알아요.
I know that I will see him when Jesus comes.
예수님 오실 때 제가 예수님 볼 거 알아요.
And I know that my husband also will see him when Jesus comes.
제 남편도 예수님 보실 거예요.
And my in-laws will also see him.
제 시어머니, 시할아버지도 볼 거예요. 시할아버지.
Christ in you.
우리 안에 있는 그리스도.
The hope of glory.
영광의 소망.
That's the difference he can make.
우리를 변화시킬 수 있습니다.
Christ in you.
우리 안에 있는 그리스도.
The hope of glory.
영광의 소망.
It's a radical difference.
전적인 변화입니다.
It's the kind of difference that it would be inevitable for other people to see.
사람들이 볼 수밖에 없는 그 변화.
Because it's not normal.
왜냐면 비범한 변화입니다.
Because it's not simply religious.
종교적인 걸 떠나서.
It is real life.
진짜 살면서 벌어진
It is abundant life.
풍성한 삶.
It is a different kind of life.
완전 다른 삶.
Christ in you.
우리 안에 있는 그리스도.
Would you like to experience that?
경험하고 싶으세요?
I do. I want for Jesus to live in me in such a way that I can know that He is actually alive in me.
그리스도가 내 안에 살아계신 거 경험하고 싶습니다.
Anybody else?
그러신 분 계세요?
Let's pray together.
기도하겠습니다.
Father in heaven,
하늘에 계신 아버지,
we thank you for that wonderful and profound teaching of the New Testament.
방금 우리에게 강력한 가르침을 주셔서 감사합니다.
What an amazing, amazing, amazingly different life that is.
완전히 완전히 다른 그 삶.
And most of us are, by comparison, we are young Christians. We're just baby Christians.
우리는 정말 성숙하지 못했습니다, 그리스도인으로서.
But we desire today, before you, to say, Lord, live in us.
우리 안에 오시옵소서.
Live in us in such a way that you can take over our lives.
우리 삶을 완전히 정복하여 주시옵소서.
Help us understand that you live in us and you surround us with your love and your presence.
우리 하나님의 사랑과 임재로 둘러싸 주시옵소서.
And that whatever happens to us has already been filtered by you, have already been thought through by you.
모든 것들 우리에게 떨어지는 모든 것들 하나님께서 심사숙고 끝에 허락하신 것인 줄 받아들일 수 있게 도와주옵소서.
And help us be thankful always. Help us be rejoiceful always.
기뻐할 수 있도록.
And help us let you live your life in our lives.
우리 안에 오셔서 살아 주시옵소서.
In Jesus' name.
예수님 이름으로 기도합니다.
아멘.
아멘. 오, we'll resume in at 11 o'clock. After a break.
I think next one doesn't have to be interpreted. Hmm? Yeah. Next one, you can go without.
Okay. We're going to learn about the church growth without me, so you can fully appreciate his sermon without me, in English only. Eleven.
You know, maybe if you're